everyone, it's me. How are you all doing? I hope you are doing very well. I've got some videos to do today, so bear with me. Some I'll upload tomorrow. I think I might do two today. Do the other two videos and then put them up in the morning. So, because I missed out last Friday's and the Friday before. But anyway, today's Thursday. It's top 10 Thursdays with me and Lauri again. I know you only got our list from last week, 2 days ago, but that was my fault. And I'll bite my nail, I shouldn't be doing it, naughty me. So yeah, anyway, Lauri was the one that done the list this week, so. And do you know what? It's been weird, but when I done my list, it was dead easy for me to do. With Lauri's list, it was so easy for me to do as well. I don't know what it must be. Because I'm smiling. Because I've spoken about this. I haven't really spoken about it, but I have spoken saying that I lost my smile a couple of months ago and I need to try and find it back. And guess what? I found it. So, we won't talk about that. But anyway, long introduction overdue. Let's get into the list. So, Lauri put top 10 things that you want to do next year for the year 2019. So, I won't go into too much detail. I'll run it through twice as I do always. So, yeah. Number 10, the first thing I put is vlog more, because this year has been hard for me because I haven't really vlogged as much as I wanted, as much like consistency, and I really want to vlog more. I want to do a lot more travel videos, because next year is going to be my last year for traveling, because I want to do quite a few places next year. I've already got January through to April booked up for holidays, so it's all exciting. Because I really want to do something next year that's going to blow everybody away. I might only be able to do it for 7 days though, that's the only problem. But I really would like to do it for 10. But I would like to take somebody with me, but it can't happen. So I might have to go on my own. So anyway, yeah, I do want to vlog more. I want to do more holiday vlogs. I want to do more personal vlogs. Because I've missed vlogging, I've missed using my camera, I've missed getting my phone out and just talking to you guys, and yeah. 9, which coincides with number 10, which I'm trying my best to do, but it is a bit difficult at the moment, but I want to carry on and basically have a structure to my YouTube channel where I've got videos like certain days of it, but I also want to like take a break as well. I don't want to bombard everybody with like 5 videos every single day. I just want to like break it up, like try and have 1 video per day and try and see if I can get the weekends off, so do 5 videos a week, but 1 a day, and try and have my weekend free unless I'm doing personal vlogs. But if I'm away, I just do like, I might even relax and just put out 1 vlog a night. Or might do vlog little bits just throughout the day, and then like do like once every couple of days. Sorry about that. Right, carry on. So yeah, basically want to have a structure to my channel. Number 8. Now this is going to be a very unusual one that I've decided to put as number 8. I know it's like far low down the list, but I'd like to try and drink more cocktails. It sounds really mad, but if the past couple of months have taught me, I need to start living a little bit, because I'm sort of like under like a little bit of a rock and it's hard. But I want to like be more fun, be more energetic, have a laugh, get out a bit more, and just be me. And just chill. But I like to want to have fun. If I have like a cocktail child army, I can have like a laugh and stuff like that. Because basically, if what I mean by drink more cocktails, I mean like social gathering, meet more people and just get out to just have a laugh. So, I'm just looking at the crystals on my top here with me. Right, so, I know I'm easily distracted today, so sorry. But yeah, I do want to try out more cocktails, because I do like to drink when I'm on holiday, but that's the only time I really drink. I never drink when I'm here, so it's like basically to try to get out there a bit more and just try new things, basically. Which comes on to number 7. Basically, I want to have more confidence. I struggle with this immensely. I struggle a lot with this. It's because for years I've always been like brought down. People have like brought me down and bullied me and picked on me and kicked me in the stomach and punched me in the elbow and my shoulder and stuff like that. It's like knocked my confidence down. And like, I just want to have more confidence, and it just drives me crazy to know that people, like, they send me like nasty comments, and sometimes it gets to me, especially like personal comments that are like a load of bullshit that somebody likes to write. Even though I don't see your comments anywhere because I blocked you, so that's why. And yet people tell me that you still slag me off on your little vlogs. And I still have a cyber stalk and it still sucks big time. So I like to have more confidence in like doing more videos about me and like get to know me stuff and just have more confidence. Even like vlogging outside, I want to have a bit more confidence vlogging outside as well. It's just, it is difficult, especially with what I've been through and stuff like that. And also, before I carry on, especially with me being having, I'll go on about it again because if people are new to my channel, I'm a 35-year-old person that suffers with Wernicke's aphasia. Basically, the left side of my brain doesn't function properly, and it takes me a bit to register things and understand things, and sometimes I just come up with stupid and daft things, and I don't mean to, like, I apologize for that, but it's here, it's on this side, and and that also knocked my confidence really badly. But when I talk about something that I'm really, really passionate about, it just flows and just flows and flows out of me, and yeah, it's like I just find things difficult and I just want to be more confident, especially with this. And like, not a lot of people like understand about it and they don't like get me and stuff like that, but I just hope one day that more people in the world accept people for having Wernicke's aphasia, which is also, people like also know, class it as receptive aphasia. But you've got to understand, you've got to take time with some people, because some people are like different to you, but that's what makes me unique as a person, and that's what people like about me. So yeah, so number 6 is go to the gym a lot more. Backstory about me going to the gym, I started the gym actually, it would have been last year. I think it's a year, because I started out originally in Fuerteventura, bear with me. Once I started, I just got hooked. I just continued to go and continued to go. Until earlier on this year. I was involved in a car accident, and I suffered nerve damage on the left side, especially to my shoulder and my knee and my hips, and I find some things difficult even still to this day. It does cause me a lot of pain. An incident just last night, I went for a Chinese takeaway for us to share. Took the bag off the guy, the counter, and as I took it off, there was a lost complete control of this arm. Food dropped all on the floor. Luckily, I grabbed it with my right hand, and even the guy said to me, "You're alright, you're okay," and I said, "I'm okay." Basically, I lost complete feeling in my left arm, and I was like, "Oh no, it's not happening again." And things like that do happen to me, and I hate it. So basically, I want to go to the gym a lot more, like next year, and strengthen this part and my abs. Number five is be successful with Skyla's college treatments. If you don't know, I am a mobile massage therapist. I come to you. You don't come to me, I come to you. You just call me up. Let me know what appointments you want, and because I have all the treatment listed in on my Facebook page, Skyla's Collagen Treatments, and anything CI, the collagen company. So go to that and you can book a treatment with me. So I just want to be a little bit more successful with that, even though this year it's been a bit slow. But I know next year I'll come out with a bang. Four, take more holidays, because to coincide with what I've been talking about, the heat helps with my bones and with the condition I have. And I'll talk more about that in a separate video, because I'm going to eventually open up to you guys about what's going on. Three, have my birthday in Fuerteventura. That is definitely on the cards, and I'm hoping that happens. Two, meet Lauri. As we talked about last week, what we want to do when we meet up. Hopefully, Lauri's coming next year to meet me, and that'll all be sorted in videos and collab videos and stuff like that. And then number one is a very, very special thing only to me. Basically, I want to keep smiling from ear to ear because of one special person. He knows who he is. So yeah, I'll run down my list again very quickly. So 10, vlog more. 9, have a structure to my YouTube channel. 8, drink more cocktails. 7, have more confidence. 6, go to the gym a lot more. 5, be successful with Skyla's collagen treatments. 4, take more holidays because of my health issues. 3, have my birthday in Fuerteventura. 2, meet Lauri. And 1, keep smiling from ear to ear because of a very special person. So yeah, I hope you've enjoyed this week's top 10 Thursdays list. Like, comment, subscribe, all that jazz. Turn that notification bell on. You'll get a grand... I was speaking too fast then. You'll get a brand new video from me most days. So stay gaudy, have unpleasant dreams, and I'll see you in the next video. Ta-ta for now. Bye. Bye. Ta-ta.